Hello everyone, this is me, Sadia here, and I'm back with the third week of October read, start from the 15th through the 21st of October 2022. This reading is going to be for the sign of Aquarius. So Aquarius, let's see how this week is going to be for all of you out there. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading, so stay tuned. And before I dive into the read, let me remind you, it's a general read. It may not resonate with everyone out there, so always pick the signs and messages that resonate and leave the rest. For personal reads, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also check out other services that I offer as well in the description box. So Aquarius, let's begin. What is coming in for you for this week time? We have our first card here, which is the Hierophant. I feel like, you know, for some of you, you might be having to deal with some sort of legal matter in this week time. And I feel like, you know, for majority of you, this whatever it is that you're dealing with, whatever it is that you're going to be you know, having to deal with, and be that in love, work, or home life situation, it seems like, you know, it's just gonna broaden up your way of looking at things. So you will be having a lot of clarity coming in for you as well in this week time, and I feel like, you know, something might come to light for you as well. For some of you, you might be hitting yourself to have some time alone with the divine that you believe in as well during this week time. You might be feeling very connected to the divine that you believe in. Let's see more cards here. Page of Cups. Wow. Knight of Wands. Amazing. Page of Swords. I feel like, you know, for some of you, you might be spending a lot of time with the divine that you believe in regarding a connection, regarding a person. You might be complaining, you might be praying, you might be trying to understand what shall you be doing as a divine guidance coming from the God that you believe in, because I feel like, you know, you would want some clarity around making a decision. Maybe for some of you, you might have been proposed by someone, somebody who wants to take things, like, you know, legally, like, you know, maybe to pursue you and to get married to you in a traditional way. I feel like, you know, if that has happened or if that comes through, you will be, like, you know, spending a lot of time to make the right decision for yourself, because you might not be, like, you know, aware of the true intention of the person that you're getting the proposal from. So you might feel like you need to spend some time with the divine that you believe in, so you could make the right choice, right decision. You might have some issues trusting the people or the kind of relationship being offered to you. So I feel like, you know, for some of you, you might be having a lot of people coming towards you, proposing you, or in showing interest in you, but maybe you are not willing to take any of those offers because you have your concerns. You don't want anything less than a traditional way of going about your love life. So that could also be on your mind, which would be the reason why you would be spending a lot of time with the divine to protect yourself from any sort of temptation that might come in for you. Let's see more cards here. Four of Pentacles. Yes. Five of Pentacles. Wow. Six of Pentacles. Under the deck, we do have the Hermit. Again, I really see you spending a lot of time with yourself, with the divine that you believe in. Now, I feel like, you know, the offer that you might be coming, that might be coming your way, could be coming from an ex of yours. And maybe you're concerned that shall you be wasting more of your time into that connection or not. Why I say the word wasting, because maybe they have left you in the past. Maybe they have cheated on you in the past. Maybe they have, like, you know, misused your kindness. So I feel like, you know, there is, like, you know, you have your guards up against this person, whoever it is that is coming in, whether they are intending for something beautiful with you or not, but you are finding it very hard to trust them again. You are not going to be, like, you know, readily saying, yeah, I'm ready to get married, I'm ready to pursue you. You will have your concerns. And I feel like, you know, maybe right now you would choose to close yourself off to this person because of the same reason. You want your time to be, like, you know, with yourself and the divine that you believe in, so you could make the right choice. Maybe they are coming in to propose you now, but you don't know, shall you trust them or not? Shall you kind of, like, you know, allow this person to play with your emotions again or not? So I feel like, you know, there will be some sort of, like, you know, situation developing here in this week time for you where you will find it very hard to make the right choice, and that is going to be the reason why you are going to close yourself up to, you know, off to this current situation, to spend some time with yourself so you could make the right choice, right decision, regardless of you know, what this person is telling you, that I want to be married to you, I want to have babies with you, I want to take care of you. You are not going to listen to that. You are just going to believe in the divine guidance that you're going to be hearing around it in this week time. So I feel like, you know, you will be spending a lot of time doing that during this week time. Let's see, what else do you need to do to have what you desire during this week time? What else should be your focus right now in this week time to make the right choice? Hunter, track down your fears and desires. I feel like, you know, the divine really wants you to know for sure what is it that you truly desire. Maybe you desire something and then you are fearful about it. You desire and wishing for something, and now when you're getting it, you are like, you know, oh my God, why it's happening so quick? So you have your doubts and fears because it's happening so quick for you. Maybe you have been praying for it to happen. So you have to track down, is it your fear or is it something that you're feeling from within? Is it divine guidance or is it just like, you know, your man-made creation in your head about like, you know, the situation might turn negative? Is it your fears which are blocking you, or is it you yourself, like, you know, feeling that something is fishy? You have to track down that for yourself to make the right decision. Then you have a traveler moving in a new direction. I feel like, and for some of you, you might be having a person coming towards you through travel. They might be traveling back to you, and maybe if that happens, I feel like, you know, you would feel like, you know, maybe they have something that they're hiding away from, you know, and they are coming towards you by keeping or leaving somebody else in their life. So you will have your concerns, you will have your doubts that if there is a third party situation there or not. But I feel like, you know, the divine really wants you to go with the flow right now. Just move into a new direction and don't let the fears stop you. It's the reason why the divine really wants you to know what is it that you desire. And then if this is what you desire, to give this a person a chance or not to give this a person a chance, don't let your fears stop you or block you. Just move in that direction if you're feeling inclined to take certain action there. Let's see some more oracle guidance here. Let's see what else the divine really wants you to focus on right now to have your life exactly the way you desire. So we have counselor. You are a natural counselor and many people benefit from your guidance and reassurance. So I feel like, you know, you are very good at, like, you know, counseling people. So make sure that you spend some time with yourself to counsel your own situation and guide yourself as if you would guide to another person that would come to you in the given situation and telling you the same story as you're going through, and see what you would have said to them. Because that would have been the perfect guidance that you really need right now. So try to be with yourself and try follow what you feel guiding to that specific someone who might be going through the same shit as you are going on, or, you know, as it is going on for you. So let's see some more oracle guidance for you for this week time. Breathe. Take several deep breaths and exhale slowly to awaken your energy and to release old patterns. Again, the divine really wants you to focus on yourself right now and then only make the right choice, rather than, like, you know, letting your, like, you know, fears block you, or letting your, like, you know, desires make you feel like maybe this is not the right thing for you to desire. Just let it all go. Breathe in, breathe out. Try to exhale negativity, try to exhale the old patterns that you might be following lately. And I feel like it's time for you to start looking at things from a fresher perspective, so you could make the right choice without letting your fear block you in any possible way. So that's what you really need to do, to be doing right now, to have what you desire. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If it was of help, do like, share, and subscribe. Till I do the next week for you guys. Take care. Bye.